questioning about all these relationships with Europe. And what do you think there's going to be an impact, almost not only at the economical, but maybe at even a higher level, now that Israel will be closer to Europe if you succeed in your plan to, you know, getting and selling more to Europe, so the relationship will increase? What do you think would be the impact on Israel-European relationship in the near future?
It's quite sure that we are going to come to Europe.
Over the last few years, maybe decade, some of the really bold leaders in Germany, Denmark, California, Texas, and China have taken a very strong position in, for many, many different reasons, of pushing renewable energy high into the agenda and requiring that renewable energy provide a goodly percentage the energy state of the country. This is going to have, and is starting to have, it's going to have a profound general impact, and clearly it has grid impact. In countries where, on the average, the solar energy or wind energy, which is the principal provider of the renewable, is, say, 25% available. In places like California, where they create a 33% renewable energy standard, that means that 33% of the overall energy of the state, of electrical energy, has to be provided from renewable. Being that solar and wind are only available about 25% of the time, that means the capacity, the amount of production capability of wind and solar have to be 120%, 1.2 times the entire state grid in order to provide that amount of energy. Other places have been even bolder, like Germany and California. There's a visionary movement are looking at putting in, requiring that 50% of the energy of the grid is going to come from renewable. Once again, if you have 25% of the time renewables are available, that means that you're going to have four times the requirement, the 50% requirement of renewable generation capacity, or 200% of grid capacity will be renewables. I started out pointing out these specific countries because they are the only countries that are actually moving towards those countries and states in the direction that have been advocating the time. Germany, in the most extreme, and their goal for 2050, being that they adhere to their other goals, makes it somewhat believable. A person like me in this field very, very much look at what people are doing, not what they say they're going to do. And Germany is actually adhered to what they say they're going to do, and their 2050 goal is to have 80% of their energy supplied from renewables. which means that they have to produce 320 times an eight and have lower energy availabilities. It might be 450% more renewable capacity than the system needs. Well, it's obvious, but it hasn't been observed, that if you have such a massive amount of capacity coming online, it's going to compete and have real conflict with that which is already delivered. Most of the history of energy development produced by coal, hydro, now nuclear in many places, which perform a base load that can't be switched on and off, provides energy when it's almost all the time. It can be turned down, up and down somewhat. And what is happening when the new solar energy and wind energy has such massive capacity, it competes with the existing coal energy, nuclear energy, and hydro, which can be turned down and not off to keep water running and fish having water and farming. So there's a massive, massive interference between the base load power, hydro, and the renewable power coming on at much, much higher renewable capacity. In places like China, which is kind of leading this effort, it's quite amazing that they have 62,000 megawatts of wind. Much of that wind in many places is what they call curtailed. They force it to be turned off 45% of the time because the time that wind is producing, coal is producing, and they can't turn off the coal. So it's a clash. Wind can get turned off, coal can't deliver. In spite of this, China has made a decision, which I think is profound, over the next 8 years, to quadruple the amount of wind supply and to add 50 gigawatts of solar to their grid. That means the combined solar wind capacity of China exceeds the total power of Germany. The total power of Russia is over 25% of the total power of the United States.